A key factor in shaping good policies is also to learn from what has happened in the past and on that basis improve for the future. And that's what the next keynote speech is going to focus on. So Per Olav Hetland, he's Inspectorate of Accidents at Accident Investigation Board Norway, and Vegard Hansen, the CEO of Norwegian Road Supervisory Authority, will explain together the potential of a safety learning system based on the analysis of recent crashes. Gentlemen, the floor is yours.
Thank you for letting us come to speak about safety learning on from accident. Closer? There you are. Yeah. Yeah, my name is Per Olav Hetland. I'm an accident investigator from the Norwegian Safety Investigation Authority.
Yeah, and my name is, Istesan. Yeah, my name is Vegard Hansen. I'm, as said, the director of Norwegian Supervisory Authority in Norway. We were created with the background of zero vision, and we are working with the objective of improving road safety in Norway. And I will be first, Per Olav will be presenting the accident in Nafstad, and I will be just touching briefly on the safety learning system that we're working with of in-depth analysis in Norway.
So, first of all, the Norwegian Safety Investigation Authority investigate accidents, I'm afraid to use that word now, but in the major transport groups and defense system in Norway. I work at the Road and Defense Department, and we've investigated a lot of different kind of bus accidents or small overlap collisions, run-off road, rollovers, and different things. But today, I'm going to talk about Nafstad, and we will be showing pictures. So this is from the report and from the accident. So if you take caution if you have to. On the 17th of November 2017, there was a head-on collision between two buses on a slippery road just north of the capital in Norway. And one driver was killed and the other was critically injured. We started to investigate this accident, and we extreme damage and intrusion to the front of the buses. After we investigated this for a while and we downloaded the tachographs and analyzed the speed to the accident site, we found that the accident impact speeds were far less than we initially thought. So one of the buses had 33 kilometers an hour and the other was 34. And there's overlap in height and overlap, quite a big overlap. So this is not a small overlap collision. And when we investigated, we kept thinking to ourselves, there's something lacking when it comes to front collision protection. So when we investigated the requirements and the regulation on crashworthiness with other groups of vehicles, we wanted to illustrate what it meant from what you see on a regulatory level to what it means in on the vehicles. So we took the front steering axle as a baseline, as you can see in the dotted line here, and tried to implement in this illustration the exposure in a front collision situation and the regulations, both requirements and what we've seen that been voluntarily been implemented. So while drivers in passenger cars and trucks is placed behind or above the steering axle and the engine, the bus driver of a city or intercity bus is placed way further down and lower than any drivers in any other vehicle groups, and with far less front collision protection requirements. So after 1.5 years, we published this report. We had 6 safety recommendations. We focus in the safety learning system, as we're talking about today, about 2. And then that's one to the public transport authority to introduce crash protection requirement for drivers as a criterion in connection with tenders for new public transport services. And to the Norwegian Public Roads Administration to consider using national regulations as a basis for improving crashworthiness of buses uses in transport. This we have done in Norway earlier with seat belts.
Yeah, and just briefly, it has been mentioned by earlier speakers today, but based on these recommendations, this is some of the measures that were implemented afterwards. First of all, Ruter, they implemented new tender requirements for buses with the requirements of constructions and collision protection for the drivers in accordance with the R29 and R93. Also, the Norwegian Public Road Authority, they suggested new regulations in Norway with in accordance or in like in with the protection for bus drivers also that was implemented in October this year by the Ministry of Transport. And this is we just want to use this as a backdrop for the system learning process in Norway for in-depth analysis, because first there is an accident, and like we have seen today, and the investigation authority, they does investigations and they give recommendations based on the safety, based on improving the safety. And what an in-depth analysis does, it provides an understanding of the root factors and the contributing factors in the accident or of the accident. And then we, as a supervisory authority, we follow up these recommendations, and we have dialogue with those involved, those who have gotten the recommendations, and we try our best to make sure that it is implemented measures that are in line with the intention of the recommendation. And with improving and implementing measures that likely will give an improved safety. Knowing we are not finished, but we're not finished because it's a continuous improvement. And I like to think as a traffic, the traffic safety and road safety, it's not a sprint, but it's more like a marathon. And we need to remember we've come this far, but we need to work further and implement more measures. And finally, there's just a few things that I want to highlight from this safety learning system, just briefly. First of all, when the investigation authority does their investigations, it's done for only learning purposes. And when they have published their reports with their recommendations, their work is over. And then it's handed over to us. And we follow up those recommendations. And what we see from this accident with several recommendations is that many people or many organizations, they have been involved in improving safety. It's not a individual act, but it's a collective work. And we need to work together on it. Many has contributed for improving the safety, as we can see from this just 2 recommendations that we have talked about today. And secondly, as an authority, we're all about sharing the results, because when we share the results, it creates an awareness and it encourages others to do the same. And some organizations, I would say, as Ruter, and we have talked about that today, they have made a way in our country in this area, and we see that other people follow along. And it's necessary because we still see bus drivers being killed in head-on collisions in very low speed.
Yeah, so this is two pictures. One is from the accident in March 2021, also a small overlap collision, and which there is an open public report on. And as people mentioned earlier today, on the right side is the head-on collision in Fredrikstad. Last December. This is still an ongoing investigation for us, but the collision speeds were low and the overlap was small. So together in this, we see that the system with the accident investigation board that we used to be called, and the follow-up and implementing and creating a collective safety improvement system works in Norway, but is it possible to learn it more faster and more internationally? We are a small country. We have not that many accidents, but we investigate them quite extensively. So I think that's we have in this system also improvements to go on, but we are getting better at it.
Thank you. So another request for joining forces and for upscaling indeed what you're doing in Norway and also learning from that in all senses of the word in other countries. Thank you so much. Unfortunately, we don't have time for questions, but thank you for your presentation.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.